Darren and Rick came up on the crash minutes after it happened and stopped on the shoulder on the eastbound lanes, opposite the wreck. They were conducting interviews when Sergeant Ramirez ordered them to leave. Watch for yourself what happened.
You get in your truck and
we're going to talk to this guy.
No, no, negative, sir. You will get in your truck and move.
Okay? Yeah, we're doing our job.
You press that trigger, boy. Get in your truck and move. Get in your truck and move.
Shoot if he wants to.
Do you want me to arrest you?
No, I don't.
Do you want me to arrest you? Then you get in your truck and you move. Plain and simple. I don't care. I'm telling you something. I'm giving you an order. You know what?
I didn't do anything.
You want to get arrested?
No.
Okay.
Just we'll go. I'll go. It's fine. I'll go.
I'm not resisting. You know what? You're not going.
I'm not resisting.
I'm not going.
I think I can get the truck and pick him up.
Go get in the truck before you go too.
Can you let him go?
Get your hands off the truck!
I didn't do anything!
Get your hands off the truck!
Look, I'm not doing anything. I'm not doing anything. I'm not doing anything, sir.
I haven't done a thing.
I'm just trying to leave, sir.
I'm going
to
get the microphone.
I'm going. I'm taking off.
What are you doing? You can't do that.
Put your hands behind your back. And Darren and Rick were detained for about 1 hour. After they were taken to the Regional Command Center, they were released within minutes. The El Paso Police Department immediately launched an investigation, and two members of the public information officers came to our studios to interview our crew and watch the video you just saw.
Police officer in Newark now faces suspension after being caught on tape putting a CBS 2 photographer in a chokehold. And as CBS 2's Christine Sloan reports, the Newark Police Department has ordered a full investigation.
Put that camera away. Turn the camera off. Put the camera away.
Put the camera away.
My man.
My man, you heard what I just said, man? Now get the camera out of here right now.
You get your hands off my camera.
This video shot yesterday shows a police officer in Newark putting a CBS 2 News photographer in a chokehold and arresting him for covering a public march.
Put your hands behind your back.
No, he's going with me. He's going with me.
You can't arrest him!
I can do whatever I want.
If you keep moving, I'm going to hurt you.
The ACLU says the arrest is disturbing because our photographer was on public property, not trespassing. In fact, they say the press's rights are protected by the First Amendment.
The police, at any rate, have no business interfering with an individual who's not obstructing, not posing a threat, but simply recording what's happening on the public street. That's democracy.
Let's move.
Okay, hold on.
No, we're not holding on.
Let's go, guys.
Relax.
You're under arrest, Buster.
I entered the unobstructed gates to the Mexican consulate in New York City in order to film the interaction between demonstrators and police on the inside from as safe a distance as possible. Things got a little tight. I did my best to stay out of the way and was focused on getting a shot. I was then asked to leave the area, and I said okay. As I was complying with the order to leave, a police officer grabbed my camera. He did not say stop, halt, you're under arrest. He didn't say any of these things. He just grabbed my camera. I didn't let go of my camera. When I hit the ground, my glasses fell off, my camera fell to the left, I reached for my glasses with one hand and the camera with the other. I was only able to grab onto the wide-angle lens of the camera. There was another hand on the body of the camera that was not letting go, and now I have left my wide-angle lens that was ripped from the body of my camera, as you can see. I think it's extremely ironic that at a protest in honor of a journalist who was shot and killed for trying to report a story that the authorities didn't want told, that I would be attacked and have my camera stolen by the police. I think it's a sad commentary on the state of our press, our freedom. If they wanted the video from my camera, there are procedures for that, and we could have followed the procedures, but they just grabbed the camera. How many more years will it be here before they'll just shoot us too?
Investigative reporter McCarron and her photographer were checking out a tip about questionable use of police and government resources in Prince George's County. They were following a county government car driven by a police officer who appears to be a full-time driver for the county's chief administrative officer. McCarron was driving. Photographer Pete Hakel was in the back seat. Suddenly, they heard the wail of police sirens and saw flashing police lights. Back at ABC 7, managing editor Dan Patrick heard a call on the Prince George's County police scanner.
Prince George's County police were stopping a vehicle they said had was suspicious in nature because there was someone videotaping them.
When we first heard sirens and saw flashing lights, we assumed it wasn't us. And then all of a sudden, we're surrounded.
She's got a gun pulled on them.
Okay, that's right, that's fine.
At gunpoint, McCarron did as she was told.
Face the front, ma'am. Now, 1 second, stand by point.
With her hands up, she walked backwards to the sound of the officer's voice. Moments later, a police officer roughly pulled her arms behind her back.
My shoulder felt like it was on fire.
McCarron's shoulder was wrenched from its socket. She may have to have surgery.
Drop the cab, Ryan.
Yes, sir.
Meanwhile, our photographer had problems of his own. At least three officers had their weapons trained on him.
Keep backing up towards the sound of my voice. Just keep holding.
I'm a backing.
Eventually, the police determined that this 5'4", 115-pound mother of three was not a threat, and they released her without a charge. But before she left, reporter McCarron had a question.
You got pulled over because a citizen that you're following. Excuse me. We're not saving it. I'm not giving an interview.
I think it's an obvious case of law enforcement intimidation.
Attorney Lucy Delglish is executive director of the Reporters Committee for Freedom of the Press.
What I don't quite understand is what would be even slightly illegal about driving around town with a video camera. There is nothing illegal about that whatsoever.
Well, I think as a legal matter, it's clear that her civil rights were violated. They cannot use their power to interfere with your constitutionally protected activities.
WJLA-TV has filed an official police brutality complaint alleging that Prince George's County police officers used excessive force against reporter McCarron. The complaint further alleges that the police officers may have known that McCarron was a journalist on assignment. If so, what we have here is a serious case of news media intimidation.